Aristotle, in his famous work, that is the Politics, he gave his views on cause of revolution and political measures by which it can be prevented. Aristotle used the word status for revolution, even though the word has different meaning. It is similar to sedition, which involves a lot of disorder and destruction. According to Aristotle, any change in the constitution or in the form of government is a revolution. For instance, the replacement of monarchy by tyranny, or the replacement of polity by democracy, or the replacement of aristocracy by oligarchy is a revolution. If a system is made more rigid or flexible, it is also a revolution, according to Aristotle. If there is an agitation against a particular class or section of the community, there is a revolution. If there is the capture of power by seditious party, even if there is no change in the government, it is a revolution. Thus, Aristotle considered any kind of change as a revolution. According to Aristotle, the most important reason behind the revolution is spread of inequality. The other causes of revolutions includes undue superiority of the few, prevalence of fear and contempt, heterogeneity of the population and the territory of the state, widespread use of force and fraud, rampant corruption, maladministration, neglect of small disturbances, disunity in the ranks of ruling class, weak position of middle class, and so on. Talking about the consequences of the revolution, Aristotle says revolution is always unwise. It achieves some good, but at the cost of many evils. According to Aristotle, revolution caused disturbances and dissolution of that social order and structure on which every political good depends. Aristotle suggested three solutions to prevent a revolution, or three remedies of revolution, that are the government propaganda in education, respect for law, justice in law and administration. Aristotle, moreover, felt that the suppression of long-established habits brings about the revolution, since the old habits persist among the people. If the constitution is to be permanent, all the parts of the society must be maintained. Aristotle writes in his book, that is the Politics, that even an autocratic ruler should appear to be earnest in the worship of gods. For if men think that a ruler is religious and reverses the gods, they are less afraid of suffering injustice at his hands, and are less disposed to conspire against him, since they believe that the gods themselves are fighting on his side. Apart from this, Aristotle also given some other measures which can also prevent a revolution from happening. That is, too much power should not be allowed to concentrate in the hands of one man or one class of men. All the classes of men in the state should be treated with consideration. No one in the state should be made to feel that they cannot hold political power. Great political offices should not be given to the unknown strangers and aliens. Those who hold public office should be prevented from involving themselves in bribery and gratification. The financial administration should be open to public scrutiny. No class of citizens should have a monopoly of political power. The highest public offices should be given only on the consideration of loyalty to the constitution and administrative capacity and integrity of character. The government should inform the public the danger of a foreign attack in case of internal revolution. If we are looking at the criticism against Aristotle's theory of revolution, the meaning of the revolution given by Aristotle is subject of controversy. To Aristotle, any change in the form of government or in the constitution is a revolution. Even though this meaning attributed to revolution may have an element of truth, it does not explain the real meaning of revolution in the modern period. Revolution usually involves the violence, but this aspect has not been highlighted by Aristotle. For Aristotle, revolution constitutes a political change. Aristotle considered inequality as the chief cause of revolution, which is true to some extent, but not absolutely. Inequality exists anywhere in the world, but revolution takes place only in few states of the world. In each state, there are different reasons for the outbreak of revolution. If we are analyzing the French Revolution, Russian Revolution, or the Chinese Revolution, we can find out that there are several reasons. For example, social, political, economic, and immediate reasons, and several reasons are there. So therefore, it is difficult to point out some specific factor as responsible for the revolution everywhere in the world. Aristotle given suggestion for ruler to take care to avoid revolutions. He said that if ruler appear to be God-fearing and worshipping, then the people will not indulge in revolution. But it's not suitable for today, because today the people want religion to away from politics. When Aristotle was talking about revolution, we can identify that he was afraid of change, as if he wanted to maintain status quo. But in today's world, wherein the change means progress, his theory of revolution became invalid.